Hey guys, now recently I picked up a couple of new joysticks for £1 each. Unfortunately, they don't work on any modern systems because they use the old Gameport, which, you know, isn't usable on any modern system anymore. In fact, you're hard-pressed to get them working, if I'm honest. You can't find motherboards with it, and you have to use old PCIe cards and hope the drivers work for it. It's a big pain and a big kerfuffle, so I had a big look around, and I managed to find this. This awesome little device here. It is called a USB Nest. Now, this thing's quite old, but it is still usable. It was designed for older systems, such as like Windows 95 and IBM PCs. However, it was made in 1993 by Rockfire, apparently. It's old. But you can find them. They're all readily available on the internet. You can pick them up. It's called the USB Nest. It is a Gameport to USB converter, with a difference. As you can see, it uses Gameport, and it goes to USB. This is workable on Windows 7, Windows 8, and Windows 10. It's usable on all these things. Everything I've tried it on, it seems to work. Even though it's made before these things even existed, the drivers still exist on the system. I'm using my joystick fine. This USB Nest comes with four modes. Depending on your joystick, you'll have to read the manual. There's some with a couple of joysticks on, there's some with like 8 buttons on. So usually you'd go from mode 1 or mode 2, but you can choose 4 different modes. You can just change it between 4 different modes. You plug it in and you're good to go. You just plug in your controller to the game port, plug it into USB, and it'll work. So I'll just show you it working right about now. Alrighty, so the first thing you're going to want to do is get your joystick that you want to use with the game port. Grab the USB Nest. 11 pin connector, and in it goes. See, in it goes, and then you plug the USB into an available slot on your computer. So once you've plugged your device in, like so, hold on, let me just plug it in, you will hear it connect, and the driver will be automatically assigned and found. The first thing you'll want to do is jump into control panel. Here we go. So let me just drag it into place. And you'll want to go into devices and printers. This may be different depending on which operating system you're on, and boom. Straight here, straight in, here is the 2-axis 4-button joystick that I'm currently using. I'm currently using some wind funny thing. So what you want to do is right-click that and go into Game Controller Settings. It will open up this little window here. It will say status is okay. Now what you can do is you can configure it even more if you want. If you want to use it with all the systems, you can calibrate it and all that. As you can see, we need to do a little calibration here. But if I just grab the joystick right now, you will see that all the buttons work. The point of view hat, the buttons, the axis, and this is using Gameport to USB. It's just a simple conversion and it works perfectly. So let me just show you it working in a game right about now. All right, let's do this. What's the worst that could happen? Did I ever mention I'm not very good at this? I wonder if I can shoot those yellow things. Yeah. So yeah, I hope this quick tip showed you how to get your old joysticks working. If you're like me and you love your old flight stick games, then it's definitely worth picking up a USB Nest. They are readily available on the internet. They're not the cheapest things in the universe, but they are the best way of getting your old joysticks to work on modern systems. So let me know what you guys think, and let me know if it works for you. I'll see you guys in the next video.